research done by a group of professionals in Cambridge, and they noticed if you give the first letter and the last letter correct, and scramble the other letters with the same length, human brain can read it. It's not an ability, it's a disability. So you try to assume what is in the mail. Stop doing that. Pay attention to each and every activity. When you write things to do list, you will be able to look at the day how you are going to spend, how you are going to use your time, how you are going to use this 1,440 minutes. When you have things in your brain, this can happen quite often because it's not organized. And the second thing, organize your place. Resource management for time management. Place for everything, everything in place. Have you seen this video? How many of you have seen that video? Can you guess what this lady is looking for? That lady is looking for something. Can you guess what may be? Any guess? Sorry? Phone? Any guess? Your life may not be worse as that.
I know most of you don't have children. Most of you, probably all.
But you may be spending your time unnecessarily like this to look for a pen, look for a pipe, look for a book, and look for shoes even in the morning. Mama, I had two shoes in the afternoon, now what do you know? What happened to the other one?
Because you don't keep the things in the right place.
Place for everything, everything in place. If your table like this, you may not be able to spend your time effectively. This 1,440 minutes will just flow like nothing. Have an organized table. Use 5S concept. Try to have a labeling system. You don't understand sometimes the importance of this label. What is the name of that? Geetika. What's the name? Sorry? Kavindu. If I tell without these two in the audience, Geetika and Kavindu, what kind of picture comes to your mind? If I say Geetika, no, it's a girl. If I say Kavindu, no, it's a boy. That's a labeling given. And if I show this pen, what color it is? It's a label. So many people do not understand the importance of this label, especially those who use CDs. You just copy something to the CD and just left it with the other side. And you won't find a particular CD, you have to play all 10 CDs to find the right one. Why don't you write the label that? Even in files, even in books, you don't write what it is. So start labeling. Start labeling. This is something I do in my life to minimize this time waste. I have a color code for my filing system. You can think about it for your life. I use 4 different color files. Green for lectures, pink for meetings, brown or yellow for my research work, blue for outside work. Green, pink, blue, I have one more color. So from my appearance, wherever the file is, I know whether it is related to lecture, whether it is related to research, whether it is related to meeting. And not only that, I write the title or label of the file in 3 different places, one here, one there, and one at the base. So whatever the direction I keep the file, I can easily pick it. Think about it. You may have tubes, you may have class notes, you may have assignments. Why don't you use about 2 or 3 or 4 different colors, depending on, either it is depending on the subject, depending on the title. You may be able to save a lot of time. And this is one practical application. How many of you use laptops? How many of you use computers? Raise your hands, those who are using computers. How many of you have USB drives on those? USB drives? Yeah, almost all computers have USB drives. Now today you use the USB drive to connect your scanner, to connect your printer, to connect your hard drive, to connect your mouse, to connect any item. That's why it is called USB. Now, while you're working, if your hard drive is connected to USB, and the mouse also connected to the USB, and the pinch also connected to the USB. You want to connect another hard drive due to some reason. And if I ask you to pick a mouse out, can you do it quickly? Most probably you will remove the hard disk. And it happens in the same way. When we go for presentations, when I finish my presentation, if I ask the assistant, please remove my computer, he will definitely remove the why? It is not labeled. So think about a label. Labeling has a great effect on wasting your time. Maybe at home, you may connect your TV, your sound system, various things into the same platform. But you won't remove. Unless you have a label, you have to take the wire and come up to the end and say, yes, it is TV, and but you will go back and remove the sound system button of the TV. Have a label. And have a place to store all these important things. When you go home, if you have a mobile, if you have a keys, if you have anything, have a proper storing place. Have a storing place. You don't have to spend money to have these storing places. These are freely available. And if you have a drawer, try to organize it. When you have an open drawer, you may put your pencils, you may put your papers, you may put your scissors, you may put your pins, and when you close it, everything will be in. When you take it out, everything will be out. And then if I try to find a pen or something, you will find a blue, small, blood dot. That's because your pins also there, because of your sharp edges also. Have an organized system. So you don't have to have most expensive things available in the society to manage your time, minimize your waste time. When I did a presentation like this for a group of professionals, next day they came and said, sorry, I could not find this system for my drawers, but I picked some unwanted boxes and cut them into pieces and stuck inside my drawers. Now it's organized. You don't have to do the same way but I'm doing. All I want to do is have an organized drawer so that you will be able to save a lot of time wasting time. In average, people spend 20 to 30% of their effective time to find lost and misplaced items. Think about yourself. How do you spend your morning searching for pens and pencils and what other stuff you need for school? And observe your parents, how much they struggle in the morning to find various things. Where's the lunchbox? Ultimately, you go under the bin. Or go to the garage, and it may be under the vehicle sometimes, or maybe with the dog's cage. You don't have to spend money. Organize your habits. You have to have a habit of practicing this. I can tell you this, but if you don't take it seriously, if you don't think, if you don't agree that it will save your time, you may not take it as a habit. We have habits. We have good habits. I want you to have this as habits. One is key, use of keys. You may not face this problem yet, but your parents may be facing this. How difficult to find a misplaced key. This is how some people spend. That is how some people find the key in the morning. And you just drop wherever you feel. Don't do that. Have a habit of storing things in the right place. Glasses. I know some people just drop glasses on tables, on bed, on chairs, and ultimately will start seeing from here. Never ever keep things on wrong place. Right habits. Never ever keep keep things on wrong place. Maybe your pens, maybe your pencils, maybe your sharp edges, maybe your files, maybe your books, actually. Everything should have a right place. Have a habit of keeping it in the right place. You will definitely minimize your time wasting. Bad habits is a major time waste. I can do one group activity. Can I ask all of you to stand up, please? Please stand up. Keep your bags down. Ready? You can stretch your arms. As high as possible, there are no pants. No, you don't have to worry. Make it straight. Can you touch the ceiling? Not yet. So raise your foot also. Can you touch? No, not yet. So little more. Little more. Little more. No. Oh my God. So give it back. No, come back. Put your hands down. Close your eyes. Be honest. Close your eyes. Please check whether your neighbor is close eyes. But take a deep breath. Hold it for 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1, and now release it with the sound. Release it. Release your. Hey, don't hold it. Release it. Otherwise, you might die. Take one more deep breath. Hold it for 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Release it with the sound. One more. Now, you are ready for my exercise. I want you to sing a song. I'll give you a countdown. I didn't ask you to open your eyes. You should keep your eyes closed. Right. Think about a song you like. Activities. Maybe you're not asked you to sing. You should sing as loud as possible. If I hear a song, that person will get a prize, a surprise. So your song should be heard. Can I ask Dr. Kumari to be the judge, please? Dr. Kumari. You should pick who sang the song and whose song or the host who's singing was heard. So Dr. Kumari will be the judge, and we have a person. Ready with the song? Right. 1, 2, 3, sing. Think about that, Dr. Kumar.
All sang. First song was Ha Ha Ha. After that, a lot of songs were there. And in the meantime.
Could we enjoy it?
Yeah.
Because you can open your eyes now. It was just a noisy other than one or two sounds came up. Shall we sing a song together?